first of all, it almost didn't happen. I mean, you had so many growing pains, but growing pains to the point of almost huge success. 10,000 zombies last year set a Guinness Book of World Records, and it was just so overwhelming to you. You just thought you'd throw a little party together and you broke a Guinness Book of World Records. Tell us what you went through with that process.
Yeah, I mean, we started it out in 2008 just as a fun little event. You know, me and a couple friends that lived in town dressing up like zombies to scare people that are eating in all the restaurants. And word spread about it year after year, and we just kept picking up more and more people, you know, thousands and thousands of people more every year. And, you know, we're all just independently running it. We're volunteering our time. We're putting it together. We're trying to raise the money to have the event so that it can stay a free event. Because that's something we're really big on. We wanted it to be a free thing that families could do in New Jersey and come out and enjoy Halloween a little bit. And, you know, I'm just one guy. It's a lot of work for one guy. And then we picked up more help every year. You know, we have the boardwalk helping. The Chamber of Commerce has been a big help. And even with, you know, the crew that we have, it's still a lot of work, and it's almost like a year-round thing to put it together.
Well, it's a success, and in the sense that last weekend, unfortunately, because of the rain and the threat of Hurricane Joaquin, we moved it here to this day, and it couldn't be a more beautiful day here in Asbury Park.
Right, it's gorgeous out.
And it's good, and we're ready for the thousands of people to take the boardwalk today at 4:00. All the events will take place down here, right?
Down at the convention hall, yeah. Come 4:00, we're gonna get everybody ready. We're gonna get you all into a little zombie character, do some stretches, some practice groans.
Well, anytime I stretch, I do a groan. So that's gonna work. Jason, the good thing about this is that because of the growing pains, it was almost over to the fact that we couldn't do the zombie walk. And then in steps John McGillion, who comes in, and it's just from Johnny Max. And he kind of saved that, and tell me how that partnership came about.
He reached out to me. I had made the announcement, you know, broke everybody's hearts in August that I was going to maybe have to step to the side because I just had a baby girl.
Thank you.
You know, my full-time job's now being a daddy, so running the zombie walk has been harder and harder this year. And he's a big fan of the event, you know, he loves it. And, you know, what he does for the town as far as his restaurants go is very offbeat and fun.